I'm gonna hit record.
Okay.
And then you can speak, and the world will hear. And you can type, and the world will also hear that.
I was just typing in the acronym because I couldn't remember what it was.
It's KAG.
No, it's no A.
KAZNGO.
The ampersand doesn't get.
Oh.
It's just KGTSMITDZ.
DZ, yeah.
Because danger zone is two words.
Yeah. Why? What? Did I say that it wasn't?
No, I always thought maybe it was one, but it isn't.
I prefer it as DZ because a lot of awesome terms have D and Z in them, like Dragon Ball Z, and then Demilitarized Zone is a DMZ, and then like all these things that are really tough, you know, for tough people.
For tough guys. Like computer DMZs.
Those are pretty, I mean, yeah, I like to use mine, even though I know it's insecure. It makes me feel like a rebel.
Yeah, it makes you feel like a tough guy.
All my ports just wide open, ready for all comers. Bring it on.
All my ports are open to all comers.
Yeah.
It used to be on a shirt with a picture of a neckbeard on it.
Fuck you. My beard barely reaches my neck.
Are we recording?
Yeah.
Oh, okay, good. We can leave a lot of pauses between topics intentionally because it makes the editing a little easier.
I like long pauses.
Yeah. Well, it's just when you're editing, it's easier to get rid of.
I'll explain right before I cough here that I'm sick. I'm still a little sick. I'm less sick than I was, but I'm still sick.
Well,
it should be known.
This is why we haven't done a podcast for a little while, because Kaz has been sick, so we decided to wait until he wasn't as sick and until I went to a party on the weekend so I would be hungover and not have a good memory of the previous week.
Can you do me a favor?
What?
Can you describe this party?
Oh, me and Andrew on the weekend went to, it was actually two things we went to. Her friend April was throwing a drag queen party where, everybody dressed in drag. All the guys dressed in drag, like, as women. Some of the women dressed as guys, but a lot of the women just dressed up as drag queens. Because, I mean, I don't know. Let's face it. It's more fun to dress up as a drag queen than as a guy. Although, I think Andrea could have made a good kind of John Waters-esque guy with, like, a little pencil mustache.
Yeah.
But anyway, that's what we did. Anyway, so we went to that, and then after that was a hardcore German sparkle party that we went to.
The German sparkle party.
That they had at the Saw Gallery. If you look up hardcore German sparkle party on the internet, you'll find a video that is basically the entire background and premise for such parties, but they're becoming more and more popular as just kind of another kind of costume party to throw for people who love going to costume parties.
Maybe and it, is this done? This is done like with a sort of a tongue-in-cheek irony, or people are taking their German sparkle parties very seriously?
I think it's a tongue-in-cheek irony based just on the seriousness or not so seriousness of the original video, and the fact that the best way to describe it is just everybody dresses up in as much sequence clothing as they can and puts a lot of glitter on their faces. And wears rubber boots. And sometimes construction hats. Or hard hats.
It'd be a hard hat, yeah.
As they're called in America.
So, yeah, you can, when you edit this up, you can put pictures of yourself at the party, which I've seen and are very nice.
And then wait.
You could put those right up there, and then you can also link to this other video, and it'll be like a whole multimedia experience. For podcast listener/viewers.
We'd never be able to do this if we had a newspaper.
Never.
It's the wonders of technology that are going to allow this these hyper
do they,
text links.
Can they print photographs in newspapers now?
Oh, well, yeah, I guess they could do some of it. Just
so they could do a little of it.
The old ways are sometimes more modern than you remember them being.
Indeed. There could also be an infograph of, like, German sparkle party popularity over the years, and it would go from like 0 to 1 this year.
Maybe they could have like an editorial on it as well.
Yeah, they could. The editor-in-chief would give his opinion about how why German sparkle parties are sabotaging Obamacare. Or something.
Yeah, well, I don't know. Maybe newspapers are here to stay. Maybe there's about to be a resurgence now that you mentioned all of their capabilities.
You could print tweets from the previous day.
Hmm.
Sort of merging the two.
Newspapers are when you want your information slightly less conveniently and with a bit more of a lead-in and a bit more of a gap between installments.
Yeah. And they could draw, like, a red line between hashtags, as they're mentioned on the page.
Right, and you could just follow it.
Just follow the line. Like, here's where we mention this again.
During holidays, like on Christmas, they could draw, like, a little Santa on a sleigh riding the links. You're good. I think it would be a good move for newspapers. They could get rid of this whole, you know, old-fashioned, overdone thing of saying, like, you know, continued on B6.
Yeah.
And instead there could just be like a ribbon that connects them.
What you do is you take your thumb and you put it on one end of the newspaper and then you slide your thumb. It's just like an iPhone interface because you're moving the paper with your thumb.
And what you do is you use a special kind of ink so that as you drag your finger over it to trace it, it changes the color of the link, and then you...
We're getting insane now. That's...
Then you know that it's a previously visited one.
That's nuts. You are being nuts.
Sorry, I went over the line. We were staying in completely necessary discussion territory there, and then I just went right off the deep end. I hope I'm loud enough. I'm speaking kind of... Just because my voice doesn't feel great today.
Speak up, then.
Alright. You're usually pretty quiet the way we record it anyway, so that was a complaint I heard from Tim on the last one, that I was too quiet.
Tim listened to it?
He listened to, like, a couple minutes of it. I don't know. I don't think he listened to the whole thing.
I didn't listen to it.
We had 21 people who we can probably extrapolate actually listened to the whole thing, and then about over 100 people have at least clicked on the first link.
You know what I was thinking I should do?
What?
Is take the first episode and cut it to, like, 3 minutes long. And, like...
Get all the fat out.
Just down to that, and then take that and make it a link to the full episode. I think that would, honestly...
Oh, it's kind of like a preview?
I guess you would call it a preview. I guess that's a good way to say it, because that's exactly what it would be.
You can do that.
No, although there would be spoilers in it, necessarily.
It's true. The chronological flow of it would be kind of interrupted.
Yeah.
It wouldn't be the true artistic vision that we had for it. It would be kind of, you know, an abridged version.
I don't know. I didn't know that you were having artistic visions. Have you seen a doctor about that?
I don't know what you're talking about.
So what's on your topics list?
Okay, a lot of it is just stuff to remind you to talk about stuff, which is fine. That's how these lists should work. I have a couple other little ones.
Should we have a long pause today here? Do you want to have a long pause?
Right now?
Right now, yeah. It doesn't work if you speak. We'll just be silent for a sec.
We'll have a long pause.
Alright. So all what's right. What's on your...
alright, look, I'll just head into this. This is in no order, and I'm just going to skip the first few things anyway. I found out today that Katy Perry and Russell Brand got a divorce.
Yeah, I found out recently that they had been married.
That didn't last, I guess.
No.
Okay. Well...
I think one reason for that might be that Russell Brand is a fucking trollish gremlin, lives under a bridge and eats goats.
I don't think that's true. I think he's a recovering heroin addict that got his start on MTV and the British equivalent to MTV, and then eventually became kind of a stand-up comedian and TV personality. I think that's what he is, not that thing that you said.
I'm sorry, I confused the two.
Okay. Kaz, what's your problem with John Carter?
Okay. I don't have a problem with the film or the story. It's basically pulp sci-fi, which is fine. And there's totally, you know, room for that.
Arthur Conan Doyle, I think.
In the world.
I'm not going to check that. I don't care.
It was John Rice Candy.
No, I think it was Sir Conan Arthur Doyle. It's the same guy who wrote...
It's Edgar Rice Burroughs, and he made Tarzan. And the movie itself, fine, great. Big budget, action flick, you know. Competently made, and people like it. The trouble...
Better than Avatar.
...is that the film was in development hell and rights hell for a very long time until Disney picked it up. Basically, it was being half-produced and half-written, you know, by a number of studios and producers for a very long time until just a couple years ago. So what I'm imagining is there are a bunch of people really invested in the project who were thinking about nothing but John Carter, right? So what they end up doing is forgetting that everybody else in the world has no idea what the fuck this is. They release it to the public under the title John Carter, and the original title that they were going to use was John Carter of Mars, which is infinitely more interesting than the word John Carter, which could just as easily be a historical documentary, or an expose, or a drama about divorce, or what the fuck ever.
Also, not... people who were fans of the books might recognize it a little more, since none of the books are called John Carter.
Yeah.
They're always called something of Mars, usually something like a princess of Mars, or...
Exactly.
Other things. Although, I don't know, I think there was one book that was actually called John Carter of Mars, but I think it's one of the later ones.
Well, John Carter as a name for a film, I mean, the producers must have thought, they'll ask, like, who is John Carter? Like, it's mysterious, but then they didn't realize that people would then ask, and who cares? Because it's just some fucking Anglo name. Like, so they've got this film, and then the trailers are really ill-produced. There was one trailer that was interesting because it takes his background where he's a Civil War general or soldier, anyway, who gets thrown through time.
I think you're confusing John Carter with General Lee, but go on.
Well, not time, but he... Yeah, well, General Lee gets driven through time to Mars and turns into a man.
John Stonewall Carter.
And then while on Mars, because of Mars's lower gravity, he has super strength. And then he has to fight for the freedom of, you know, thus and such obscure alien word.
He's sort of like Superman, I guess.
Yeah, he turns into Martian Superman.
And except that, without the...
It's silly, but it's whatever. I mean, but John Carter doesn't evoke any of Martian Superman to me. Like, if they called the film Martian Superman, it would be a box office smash.
I think a lot of people are illiterate and don't read books. I don't think they knew that movie even takes place on Mars, because it just kind of looks like it's in the desert.
It looks like it's in some, like, post-apocalypse desert type thing. It's just people. There's no aliens visible, really, in the well, there's a couple aliens, but they're just monsters, and they could be anything.
The problem is a lot of the scenes with the aliens were in CG.
Yeah.
And there's a law that when you...